we create a modern myth? Do we
around 1 o'clock in the morning, like I say, we were heading back from a trial, Bruce and I, on that particular road, stretch of highway on the island, and we had a gentleman in front of us from the island who was guiding us that evening, and I seen his taillights crest the hill, and the next thing you know, all I seen was headlights in silence.
It was a drunk driver that caused the crash. His blood alcohol was 0.243. He had gotten in a fight with his girlfriend that he had been drinking very heavily. He grabbed her car keys, took her car, and headed home. That's where he met Bruce and Jason in the truck.
He was doing an approximate speed of 178 kilometers an hour in my lane sideways when he hit me. I remember yelling and screaming. My feet were crushed. This can't be happening. Blood coming down my face. This isn't real. I'm alive. What about my passenger? Is he all right? Is he there? Where is he? Looking at Bruce, thinking, you know, this really can't be real. And seeing him looking back at me, and I couldn't help him. I couldn't move. That was the last moment I seen my friend.
We got up to Moncton, and an ambulance came behind us, and we saw Bruce wheeled in. And they wouldn't let us see him right away, and then the doctor came in a little while later, and they said there was a 99.5% chance that he is brain dead, and you should think about organ donation. And we were talking to Bruce and holding his hand and watching him laying there in the bed and knowing that there was absolutely nothing we could do. And you're trying to make deals with God and make deals with him to wake up and he'll be all right, and he wasn't.
I woke up there in the hospital, and I remember Steve coming in. Tell me that Bruce had died. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't do anything. The only person that could have done anything there was the person that got behind the wheel that was drinking. He made the decision to kill my friend. He made the decision to make an impact on my life so hard. I'll suffer for it for the rest of my life. He's made the decision to make other families suffer.
The night before, we were celebrating your birthday, and the next night you have your friends around you helping you grieve because you've lost your child. And it was just so hard. Goodbye.
Goodbye.